Assalamualaikum dear students, welcome back to the other topic of this process of strategy. So now we will be discussing about how we can analyze our process. We discussed some strategies. We have four sort of strategies, keeping in view the strategy of the business. Now we will be discussing the other topic. So let's first discuss about the equipment selection. Selection of the equipment is also very much important. What sort of equipment you are going to select for your plant, for your production, in order to achieve your desired goals? Because it requires a lot of things. It is the complex, and because we have the alternate methods may be available. So important factors, we need to consider cost. What would be the cash flow, market stability, quality, capacity, flexibility. Selection of the plant or equipment is so much complex decision. We need to see our capacity. We also need to see the flexibility, that if we are going for the mass customization, then would it provide the proper flexibility that we wanted? And what would be the market stability? What if the technology is going to be changed, then how we are going to get that? Would that be sufficient and would go in the market? So cost is very high to buy the sort of equipment. Now we'll discuss something about the process analysis and the design. So we have multiple tools through which we can analyze our process. So this is the technical part that you need to understand in detail. So let me start. So the first question that we need to answer in the company, is the process designed to achieve the competitive advantage? Is our process is achieving the competitive advantage or not? Are we getting the differentiation, strategy? Maybe we are competitive because of the response strategy. Maybe we are competitive because of the low cost strategy. So everything is linked with your business strategy, right? So we also need to answer that, does the process eliminate the step that do not add the value? So we have a lot of steps in the process which do not provide the value. So we need to see. The other thing is, does the process maximize the customer value? And the last thing, will the process win the orders? So we need to see that is our process sufficient and enough that is going to give answers of this question. Be competitive, eliminate the wastage and give value to the customer and win the orders. So let's see in detail how we are going to analyze the process. One of the tool that we use to analyze the process is flowchart. Through flowchart we can analyze the process. It is the simplest form available, shows the movement of the material. And we have the flow chart available, which is shared by in the very start of the slide, the Harley Davidson. It was flow of the things that were going, how the material will go and how we are going to produce the thing. So this is the only flow of the material. The second tool that we use to analyze the process is the time function mapping. Time function mapping shows the flow and time frame. So this is bit advanced with respect to flowchart. This also show the movement with the time frame. So let's see. So here is the example. In previous sort of flowchart, we have just the flow of the things. But here we have also time slots. So let me discuss this time function mapping, process mapping, also called the process mapping. This is the example giving for the there is the printing and extruding operations at American National Company. It's discussing the time function mapping. So number one, here is the customer. Here we have this in y-axis we have the required things that are going to be done, and in the x-axis we have the time frame. So first customer placed the order and it required 12 days. Then we have sales process the order, then this order goes to the weight. Then we have production control weight, it requires 13 days. So weight is there, so it requires 13 days to complete the things. Then we have plant A. In plant A, the work is done in the one day. Then we have warehouse. The product is being sent to warehouse. It would require 4 days. Then we have plant B. In plant B, we have sort of exclude part. Then we have move and wet, because in the plant's warehouse, we need to move and wet. Then we have this part. Then you have final, you know, transport product move to the final customer. So order placed by customer to the final customer, which require 1 day. And this process require 9 days. So this whole process require almost 52 days to complete this. Now we need to make this, you know, target. How we are going to reduce the non-value addition into the process. So this is our target time function mapping that we design, keeping in view our current framing. So this tool help us to define how we can eliminate the time frame. So we decrease this 12 days into 1 day because of some methods, because of some technology, maybe self-service process. So we reduce the order product in process. Whenever we place the order should be quickly go to the production. So there would be only 1 day. So we also introduce some sort of plants, and we also, you know, design our process in a such a way that is going to reduce the time. So once the wait was 13 days, now here is wait is only 2 days, because the printing is going to be done here. So the whole process required, and the move would be, you know, the product would be to the customer within the 6 days. So we have eliminate a lot of non-value addition area. So this is how we call the time function mapping help us to analyze our process. So this is the simple examining. The other tool is process chart. Process chart is the third tool that require. We have multiple symbols, time and distance, that help us to identify how we can reduce the time and, you know, non-value added time that is going to create no value. So objective and structure way to analyze, record the activity that keep up to the process. They allow to focus on the value added activity. So we are going to reduce the non-value added and we are going to increase the value added activity. So let's see. So this is the classic example. This is the hamburger assembly process. So in the hamburger assembly process, what is their process? So let me discuss. So they have given the sort of symbol. So circle is in, you know, showing the operations. This arrow is showing the transport. And this square is showing the inspection. This D is showing the delay. And this V sort of, you know, triangular showing the storage. So we are going to analyze. This is the distance in feet. This is the time in minutes. And this is the symbol in chart. So we have process description. Meat paddy in storage, we have transferred to, you know, brawler. Then we have brawler. Then we have visual inspection, transfer to the pack, temporary storage. So we have multiple steps to have the hamburger ready. So we have calculated the value added time with respect to the operations time divided by total time. And how we are going to calculate this, you know, operations time? So we need to identify the value added time. So if we talk here, so this line is showing somehow the value added techniques in the first part, which is meat patty in storage. So if you see, the triangular is in the storage. So this line is going to be drawn from triangular. This step is only having the triangular. Then the other thing is transfer to the broiler. So in the broiler, we need to have the sort of this transport. So it is going to be transferred, required some sort of transport delay, transport. Then we have operations in the boiler. It would cook, so it requires certain operations. So we calculated the all the things in such a way, and we also find out that the value added time is 85.7%, and we have this total operations time. So we calculated the time of the value added through this, you know, line, and we divided by the total time of the process, which says that 85.7% is going to add the value and the remaining part is non-value added time. So this is the process chart. The other two that we use is the value esteem maps. So value esteem map is the sort of very easy techniques in which it's bit tricky to indeed. So it's the diagram that represent the process. It can be current state or desired state. So diagram may include ways how to process get requested, step in completed the process. We need to describe the words and time and solution area. So detail example of this value esteem maps is provided in your book. You can go through and identify how it's going to work. So we need to identify activities and we need to have the collaborative access steps. So you have this sort of plan. So you can attempt and understand this example in a better, because it detail in your book. So let's see further. Can I open the book? So it require my time. So it's okay if you have any question with respect to the value stream, so we can discuss in our discussion platform. Okay, so the we discuss a lot of tools which are very much important for the production process. But for the service process, the important thing is the blueprinting. What is the process of the service industry? So once we are going to have the process to understand the process of the service industry is the blueprinting. Service blueprinting is the process analysis technique that focus on customer and provider's interaction. In the service industry, most component is the interaction with the customer. So we need to analyze that process. So here I have given the example. I hope it's not that much clear, but I try. This example is available in your book. I am going to explain it a bit. So we have three levels. This is the level one of the customer's process. This is the level two of the customer process. And this is the level three of the process. So each process requires different sort of problems, different sort of solutions, and different sort of strategy. So this POCA yoke addresses the potential failure, and this F is denoting the area of potential failure, means the failure can occur. So this is the blueprinting. So they have also defined. So let me, the first part, this is actually the service blueprint for the service at Speedy Lube. They are Speedy Lube provide the car services to different customer. So this is the blueprint of the car service industry. So what they are going, though, as customer come, they greet, personal greeting, service diagnosis. These are the major parts that we are going to do. The personal greeting, service diagnosis, we need to perform the services, then friendly close. In the sort of personal greeting, so we have multiple levels. The first part is the customer arrive for the service in 3 minutes. So we may have some sort of failure, potential of failure, maybe it took more time. So you need to have the sort of what you need to provide. So bail-in gateway in case customer arrive was unnoticed. And the other failure that we can have, if customer remain in the work area, offer coffee and reading material in the waiting room. So potential failure area, we can provide some sort of things in order to, you know, entertain our customer. Warm greeting and obtaining the service request. A service request is being obtained, so we are going to have the standard request. So a standard request will go to determine the spec, what is the problem and what is the required, you know, needed services which is required by the person, I mean customer. Then if a standard request is rejected, then you need to direct to the customer again in waiting area. Then you have this, can services be done, and you know, does customer approve? If customer approve, then it is available, then if yes, then it would go to perform the activity. If not, then you need to notify the customer. Then you need to notify the customer, and then the customer would, you know, depart. Customer depart to the gate. So this is how we are going to do this. And this is the performance actually. If perform required work, you need to see, is it going to be, you know, work done or not. In the first level, so we need to train and give a lot of information to the customer, because they are going to greet the customer and saying goodbye to customer, and customer pay the bills. In second level, we have also high interaction with the customer. We are going to greet the customer, we are going to talk to the customer, discuss what is their problem, we need to notify to the customer, and we also then say to customer bye. This last area is, this is your hidden area, which is not the direct interaction with the customer. So here you are performing your services. This required more quality check and balance. This required more detailed training to our employees. So these require sort of more information to the customer. So in this example of the blueprinting, so we can, design and elaborate complete process of the service industry. So a special consideration for the service industry process, so we have sort of interaction with the customer often affect the process performance adversely. So that's why it's important, you need to see what customer actually want, and interaction and customization is needed. So this is the other sort of aspect, is we provide customization in the production process. Same, we can give customization in the service process. So let's discuss something about customization available to the service industry. This is the degree of customization, low and high, and degree of labor, high labor intensive and low labor intensive. If it is the mass service, and we have 3-4 sort of services. We have mass services, we have professional services, we have service factory, we have service shop. If we discuss that we have a low customization and high labor intensive work, so example is the commercial banking, retailing, where the labor is low but the customization is also low. Then we have boutique, they have the moderate customization to low customization, but moderate labor services available. Once we talk about the other low degree customization but low labor intensive, we have warehouse, where we have very low labor but we have low customization. We have airline industry, we have limited services stocks, and we have fast food restaurants, where we have the low customization and also the low labor intensity. So now we discuss about some sort of customization respect. We have professional service, in which we need to have the high customization. If there is a high customization, then you need to provide the high labor intensive. So private banking, we have high customization, but labors, the people who are working in private banking, who are providing the customized plans, customized insurance, customized accounts, so they are more labor intensive. So this is the general you have different sort of things that is available in the high service industry. We have general purpose law firms, which provide high customization but and also very high labor intensive. Now once we have the service shop, this require high customization but very low system. This is the ideal state where we can introduce a lot of automation. So this is the law clinic, the law clinics. So specialized hospitals in which we have customization but with low labor interference. We have fine dine restaurants, very high customization. We design the restaurants and design the menu with respect to the customer, but very low customer interaction is there because it's already the professional services. Then we have hospitals, which is a specialized hospital again. So in this part, it is recommended that if there is a service shop, try to introduce a lot of automated systems. It would increase your performance. Once we are going to provide the professional services, so we need to train our labor in a more diligent way. Once you have the low degree of the customization but the labor is very high, so you need to train your people in a very good way. Once you have the sort of low customization and a very low labor, in this category we can introduce a lot of automation system. So you know, airline industry has, you know, introduced a lot of technology based thing. Your bags are being scanned automatically, your e-tickets are going to be, you know, self-check-in, self-checkout system. In the fast food restaurants, once you visited the McDonald's or the KFC, so you have the self-services system, more automation system. So this is how going to improve your service processes. Even in the McDonald's, recently they have introduced those tablets. You need to choose your product and you need to order it by yourself, and they say you to wait for few minutes and they would deliver it. Because there is the low labor interaction. So here you can introduce more and more automation. Improving the service productivity. So these are certain examples which are going to be discussed how we can improve the service productivity. One technique is the separation. Structuring service so customer will go where the service is offered. We are going to structure everything. Like in the bank customer, they know from where they will open the account, who is the loan officer, who is the teller depositor, who is the person going to give the loan. So you created a separation of each department. It creates ease for the customer to get the services. Like in our finance department, we have, fees deposit separate department, salaries separate department. We have created the separation. The other strategy is the self-service. Like we have seen in a lot of supermarket store, self-service, so customer examine, compare, evaluate by their own, let them evaluate their product. So supermarket departmental store is one of the example of the service, self-service. And even in, I give the example of McDonald's, they introduce the self-service concept in which we are empowering customer to evaluate, compare and decide. Then we have postponement. What is this? This is the customizing at delivery. Means, let's suppose customizing when at delivery rather than at production. Means whatever we are going to, you know, customize, we will deliver at your doorstep rather than we are going to make it in the production, right? Then focused, restricting the offering. So it is also important that in the service industry we should have certain focus. We cannot put all the eggs in one cart. Means we cannot offer a lot of things that we cannot control and manage. So we need to have the limited menu restaurants. Then in the service industry we have modules. The other strategy is modules. Modular selection of the service, modular production. How? In investment and insurance selection, you have the sort of portfolio pools. They have portfolio of investment. So this is one of the module. So this is the other group of insurance. So you have different modules available. Like we have pre-packaged food modules in restaurant. So we can create a modules in order to facilitate our customer. Then the other and very interesting part is automation. Separating services that may lead themselves to some time of the automation, like ATM, automatic teller machine. This is one of the automation, and we have other sort of automation. Like we have this RFID system where we, you know, just show the card to our library gate and we are going to check in. So this is the automatic. Scheduling, very important. This is the precise personal scheduling. Scheduling like a ticket countering in 15 minutes in travel at the airport, so we can create a very good scheduling. Then training, clarify the service option, explaining how to avoid problems. Investment counselor, we have the, you know, a funeral doctor, directors, we have after sale maintenance personnel. So you need to give a special, you know, trainings to those all people. Now we'll discuss something about production technology. What are available technologies that are suitable for productions? It provides the competitive advantage, it is more flexible, and it is very important to get it right. So we have multiple examples. The first example is the machine technology. Machine technology is used to removing the materials and also cutting in the same part. So we have multiple machinery. We have blades plan, like a Gillette blades is being cut automatic. We have floor cutting plants, like in the Lou biscuit gum factory. We have machines, they are going to, you know, automatic machine, they are going to, you know, cut the floor in the size of biscuit. So we have machine technology, right, in the production. The other is automatic identification system, that is somehow we call RFID, which is the, you know, automatic identification system, like POS, point of sale. In POS point of sale, you have the self identification. You just show the bar to the RFID and it shows the price. Like we have Metro Bus in Dubai. Once you visit Metro Bus in Dubai, you have different cards. You just go to the self check-in and self checkout. You show your identity card. The money is going to be deducted from card and you are going to check into the metro train. Again, once you come back from metro train, again you show your card and it is going to be deducted your amount. This has become the more automatic identification system. The other in the production system is the process control. Process control is very much interesting. We need to have the technology that control the quality. We have, let's suppose in the process control, I have given the example of Lou Biscuits company. We have multiple line to identify right biscuits. So Lou Biscuits have the different sort of products categories. So they have the tuck biscuits, they have candy, they have super. So this is the multiple sort of their products. So in the process control, once their product are being packed and they are going to be sorting, once they are going to be shipped, so they have this process technology which sort the product. So they have automatic line available. There is a one machine, little machine available in all the line. So they read the barcode and they send the product to the same product line. If the product is of the Lou biscuit, so they send the packet of the Lou biscuit in the same line. If the biscuit of the candy, so they send the product of candy while reading the barcode to the candy line. So this create a very less error chances once they are going to be shipped. So we are going to have the same biscuits. So it is not mandatory that we are going to have the different sort of biscuits in sorting. So they have this process control system. The other is vision system. We have a lot of cameras, CCTV cameras. We have high security system by scanning the photographs. So in vision system, especially in the production technology, even in the service technology, we have a high security system in USA, in which if they wanted to identify any person, so they just insert the photograph and this photograph would scan all this wherever the security cameras are available. So that photo would be scanned by all the people faces. They would identify this face person is available in the country or not. So this is also the one of the high vision system. The other is robot. We have multiple robots available. Now we have, what is the work of robot? They grab the things, they properly move and they properly, uplift the things. So this is the work of the robots, especially in the welding. In the welding of the material, robots are being done where you require the complete consistency, accuracy of doing the work in the same manner. So robots provide more accuracy, more consistency, less errors, more function. So painting of the parts of the car, so it's also done by the robots. So the other is the automated storage and retrieval system. Like we have an automatic warehousing system. We have it is very much challenging to manage your warehouse, which product you will place where and how you will retrieve that product is again the challenging task. Let's take an example of a room where you place everything. Once you want it to retrieve, it become very difficult to identify which product to pick. So we have a lot of automatic system which manage your warehouse. How you manage your warehouse, this is also one of the interesting part. This is the complete, you know, mini course to manage your warehousing, especially in automatic warehousing. So they have RFID, checking balance system, scheduling, if something is going to be, you know, reduced, so they are going to, you know, order it before it goes down. So this is how it is important to have the automated storage and retrieval system. Then we have automated guided vehicles. So we have a lot of vehicles which are available, like robots who move around the cities and provide the things which is required. These automated guided vehicles are very much important when where there is a very much dangerous work, where the work is very much risky. Like we have the vehicle to supply food and medicine to jail and prisoner. So in the jail of America, where they place the highly dangerous criminal, so there are vehicle, you know, automated vehicle, you know, installed. So they actually share their food and other medicines to their prisoners. The other thing is flexible manufacturing system. You need to have the flexibility in your overall production plant, which would help you to customize the product. Then other thing is computer integrated manufacturing. The example is like a CMS, campus management system. Computer integrated system, it helps to, from all the aspects, from order to the final customer, once your whole process is being computer based, so your whole plant is going to, you know, rotate with the help of integrated information. The classic example is being given in your book, so you can go through this complete integrated system which is going to help you out in all the processes. So we are going to talk about the technology in services. Nowadays service is also introducing a lot of technology, so let's see some of the example. So we have point of sale, we have automatic diagnosis machine. So you have a little device which, you know, test your urine, which you have automatic, you know, diagnosis machine, like which check your sugar. We have also security scanner available in the airports. So we also required the technology in the service industry. So there are certain examples how they are going to impact the technology into the service industry. So example is the financial services. We have debit card, we have electric fund transfer, we have ATM, we have internet stock trading, online banking. In education sector, we have online newspaper, journals, we have assignments websites, and we have smartphones for the reading like we are doing now. In utilities and government, we have automated 1-person garbage truck. This garbage truck is being installed in one of the country of the Europe. They actually, you know, assign one truck to the individual ID. So this is how the automated 1-person garbage truck. Then optical mail scanner, we have a lot of flood warning system installed. Then we have a lot of things like we have control energy usage in the cost. We have in restaurants, we have wireless order for the waiter to the kitchen. We have, you know, robots. We have different sort of, you know, transponders on the cars that track your sales and everything. In communication, we have the Kindles, e-books, where we, you know, see the e-books and read the e-books, Kindles, you know, the Kindles, right? Hotels, we have self-check-in concept into the hotels, where we have electric locks with the chip-based ID cards. In wholesalers, we have point of sales, we have e-commerce, we have different sort of RFID. In transportations, we have automatic toll booth, we have, you know, navigation system, we have Wi-Fi in automobiles. In healthcare, we have online patient monitoring system. We have robotic surgery. They perform the surgery of the people, which is more accurately, right? In airline, we have the ticketless travel, scheduling, internet, and we have a lot of things in our service industry. So technology has going to, you know, dramatize all the services. So let's discuss the last part of this chapter, the process redesign. It is very much important that whatever process we are going to follow, we need to redesign that process again and again in order to make it more flexible and efficient. The fundamental rethinking of the business's process to bring out dramatic improvement in the performance. So here I've given the example of the Shell. Shell actually redesigned their process. Shell lubricants, for example, reinvested its order fulfillment process by replacing a group of people who handle different part of an order with one individual who does it all. So they turn around their whole process. So Shell has cut the recycle time for turning the order into cash by 75%, reduced the operating expenses, all by introducing a new way of handling the order. Time, cost, customer satisfaction, that enhance the whole processes. So it is very much important to study your processes and redesign your processes. So thank you very much for listening this clip. We have covered this chapter. If you have any question, we can discuss in Zoom session.